8:05 p.m. 13 minutes into the flight. The aircraft is climbing through 8,500 meters on its way to a cruising altitude of 10,600 meters. Then, without warning, a massive bang. The aircraft starts to vibrate violently. A routine flight turns into every air traveler's worst nightmare. Up on the flight deck, Captain Hunt and First Officer David McClelland feel the vibration. Sitting in a window seat over the wing in row 14 is healthcare worker Gareth Jones. He's busy dealing with a panicking fellow passenger.
The lady that was next to me, Teresa, was distressed. So I started to talk to her to try and calm her, but also to help me, because it wasn't stress-free for me either.
Gareth has good reason to be worried. His seat gives him a clear view of the plane's wing. And what he sees fills him with foreboding.
I could look out of the window and see trail of spark-like emissions from where the engine would be.
From their seats in the cockpit, Captain Hunt and First Officer McClelland can't see either of the two engines, so they don't know about the sparks. Like all pilots, they must rely on their cockpit instrument display to diagnose the problem. The new display on the 400 Series 737 is unfamiliar to them, but it's state-of-the-art technology. Hunt and McClelland scan the screens and LED instruments. They diagnose an engine problem and shut down the faulty engine.
Throttling back.
Hey.
Okay, shall I go through the...
The terrible clunking and vibration immediately cease. The 737 is now behaving normally again.
You're approaching 1,000th level.
But safety rules call for the crew to land the plane as soon as possible.
Let's get a turn going for East Midlands.
Hunt is in luck. Air traffic control clears him for an emergency landing at East Midlands Airport, just 10 minutes flying time away.
Control, flight heading 090, be vectoring for the ILS.
Roger, Midland 92, descending flight level 120.
8:20 p.m. Another, even louder bang rocks the aircraft. The passengers realize that the noise must come from the plane's last remaining engine.
The whole plane shook. It was like something touched the plane and stopped in midair. And at that point, frankly, my blood just went cold.
Now there are more vibrations, worse than ever.
Vibration was incredible. It was almost impossible for me to focus on Chris, who was sitting in the seat beside me. I remember thinking, if this keeps vibrating like this, the aircraft is going to fall apart.
I can remember being absolutely terrified, not really knowing what was going on.
Gear down, and flat 15.
Air traffic control clears Captain Hunt to descend to 600 metres.
Final pitch, Steve.
They must get the plane down and fast before their last engine fails altogether.
Thrust is going. Tell them we've got a problem with the other engine.
Then, everything goes silent. The plane's last engine has given out. The passengers now know they're going down. Captain Hunt has lost both engines. With no forward thrust, the plane is now fighting a losing battle with gravity.
6.6, 2.10 knots.
Hunt orders the first officer to try to restore power. McClelland begins the re-ignition sequence, but they're losing height rapidly. Now the left engine catches fire.
Fire, shall I do the fire drill? She's not going.
The 737 is dropping out of the sky. Captain Hunt's control column starts to shake violently. The ground proximity warning system tells him he's coming down too quickly. But Captain Hunt is all out of options. The ground is coming up fast.
Somebody on board said, Jesus, we're all going to die.
Hunt pulls the nose up to stretch the glide. He keeps the aircraft in the air long enough to clear the village of Kegworth. But Captain Hunt knows it's all over. 10 seconds from impact. Of the 126 passengers and crew on board, 47 lost their lives. For the survivors, nothing can erase the memory of that dreadful night. But they have rebuilt their lives. Chris Thompson and Nick Stevenson both recovered from their injuries. They're still in business together in Northern Ireland. Kieran Dynan is now married with a young daughter.
You know, you still worry about things, but I don't worry about things like I used to anymore. I think all my bad luck came at once, and nothing ever as bad is going to happen again.
Debbie Griffith left the airline industry to train as a nurse.
You can't go through a plane crash without changing. It's made me live for the moment. I've always been fairly happy-go-lucky, but I've never felt bitter. I've never felt, why me, why not me? I'm nothing special.
Gareth Jones's physical injuries on the night were minor, but the emotional scars are still with him.
You did feel dirty afterwards that, you know, why me? Why did I survive? What had I done that was special? And to a degree, that lives with me to this day. I don't know why I escaped, apart from picking a lucky seat.
The Boeing 737 is still the world's most popular aircraft. Today, a 737 takes off somewhere in the world every 5 seconds. Its safety record is one of the best in aviation.